Truly Hard Seltzer. Please drink responsibly.
Pardon the interruption, but I'm Mike Wilbon. Tony, NASA announced this new class of astronauts today.
Tony Kornheiser, I wanted to be a part of it, but apparently they insist you leave your attic.
Imagine so that. Imagine the nerve. Is this the part of the thing that Michael Strahan is participating in? Is this Strahan going into space?
I have no idea.
I think he is.
He's going to go, Michael Strahan is going into space?
I read or heard that discussed. Yeah.
It is the last thing on Earth I would want to do.
Last.
It's the last thing on Earth.
Dead last.
Didn't William Shatner went into space? He went into space. I don't get it. Welcome to PTI, boys and girls. In today's episode, Kyler Murray is back. The Chiefs win again and the college football playoff is set. But we begin today with one of yesterday's two most stunning plays. Now, one was Detroit's game-winning last-second pass, which we will get to later. The other was John Harbaugh's call to go for a two-point conversion with 12 seconds left against Pittsburgh after scoring a late touchdown. A point after by Justin Tucker would have tied the game and sent it into overtime. Wilbon, did Harbaugh make the right call?
Tony, I don't know about the right call, but he certainly made the understandable call once he explained it, which he did immediately. As you know, in real time, because you and I were on the phone, we are both screaming because I remember your sentence. Well, Tucker comes on, this game's going to overtime. And I just remember.
That's exactly right.
I remember thinking the same thing, except I was a few seconds ahead of you in my broadcast. And you see Lamar Jackson, he has a look on his face like, what? What are we doing? Because it had to have surprised him in the moment. And so, yes, it's a shocker in the moment, but Harbaugh comes right out, talks about the injuries to his corners, and said, no, we got to go for the win here. So he didn't want to go out there with backups to the backups and all of that and play in overtime. So I get it. I didn't get it in live time, but I got it once he explained it.
So I'm going to tell people the details of what you were just talking about. We were on the phone when this was happening,
yeah.
And I said to you, of course, Justin Tucker, the best kicker in football, you kick the extra point, and then he wins the game in overtime from 50 to 55
that's
yards, because
right.
That's what he does.
60, yeah.
And then, because your TV is about 20 seconds ahead of me watching the red zone, I hear you go, oh! And I go, what? What? And you say, he's going for two. And then, because it stayed 20 seconds ahead, later you went, oh! And you ruined the ending for me because it was obvious that they didn't get it. Look, I'm going to give Harbaugh the benefit of the doubt because he's won a Super Bowl.
Yeah.
And he's been there a long time. But earlier in the year, Mike, everybody remembers when he said to Lamar,
you want to
go for it, right? We're going to go for it.
Yes.
That was a fourth down play against Kansas City, and they won that game. This is their DNA. They win games close and they win games late, but they don't score any points, Mike.
Not
Baltimore
lately.
Last four games, 10, 16, 16, 19. That's not a Super Bowl offense. It's just not.
No, and remember, one of those games, the one in Chicago, where they scored 16 and won, they didn't have their guys. Lamar didn't play. Half the team was out sick. So, okay, but it's your point is still well taken. It's three games. And, Tony, they're struggling. Maybe defenses, to some degree, have caught up with them. He does get the benefit of the doubt. But again, you saw the body language, and afterwards, when Lamar slammed his helmet, you can be angry even when you understand something. So Lamar is privy to that information a lot quicker than we are, but it's still a loss.
Yeah. One small note, you and I and everybody else in the world thought Pittsburgh was dead, and they may still be.
They could still
be. But not today.
No, not
today. That's
not
a big win.
Huge.
Big win.
Huge.
Big win.
The Cardinals lead the NFC with a record of 10-2 after beating aforementioned hapless Bears in Chicago. Kyler Murray returned, ran for two touchdowns, threw for two others. In the AFC, the Chiefs are tied for the best record in the conference after beating the Broncos for their fifth win in a row. Tony, which team had the more significant win yesterday? Cardinals, Chiefs?
I think they're both very good wins. I do. Arizona went on the road in very bad weather conditions, and they beat Chicago. But as you say, Chicago's not a good team.
No.
They're nothing at the moment. So I will say it's Kansas City, because Kansas City, even though they were at home, Kansas City beat a divisional opponent and beat them down. They only allowed 9 points
defensive
to Denver, and that's nothing. And Kansas City, in this five-game winning streak, Kansas City has given up 52 points. That's 10 points a game, Mike. That is a Super Bowl defense. The intriguing thing about the scenario in Kansas City is that Patrick Mahomes, in the five-game winning streak, has been less effective statistically than he was in the first seven when they were 3-4. Throwing a lot fewer touchdown passes, 7-5 games compared to 18-7 games. And what it feels like is that someone said in a big team meeting, you know, Patrick, you don't have to do this all by yourself. We got a whole team here. Let's go with the whole team. And that approach has benefited Kansas City enormously.
Playing defense usually benefits anybody. When you have a player as great as Chris Jones and you move him inside and allow him to wreak havoc from that more natural position as opposed to being in the glamour spot on the end and rushing the passer, you know, it's a dirty job that somebody has to do playing inside on that defensive line. And Kansas City's defense has been so much better since they've done that, Tony. And Mahomes can't do it all by himself anymore because, again, as you like to say over the years, the other team has coaches and they get paid too. They have scouts, they have coaches, they have assistant coaches, and they're all saying, we're not letting Patrick Mahomes go 50 yards down the field every other series. So, Cardinals had the better win. Well, not better. The more important win, Tony, because they took control. The Cardinals have control of the NFC. The Chiefs do not have control of the AFC, and both wins were
totally
significant.
Right.
But I'm going to go with the Cardinals because they went into a bad weather situation, a dome team. And they kicked the Bears' butt. They really did.
So I will say this, that's so surprising with Mahomes. The last two wins, he has no touchdown passes. We never would have figured that. You're right about Arizona. These two teams could be Super Bowl teams.
They could be.
Arizona's really good. And if they get the bye, they don't ever have to go into bad weather again. They don't have to go
to
Green Bay.
That's right.
Green Bay would have to go to them. So that's important. The college football playoff is set. There are no surprises. It's Alabama, Michigan, Georgia, and Cincinnati. There was no chaos to change that. Well, Vaughn, you and I watched all these games. Your thoughts on Alabama beating Georgia, Michigan cruising, and Cincinnati making the playoffs?
Yeah, no surprises. For a while, I thought Cincinnati was in a pickle. They were up 14-13, excuse me, for a long stretch in that game, Tony. The Michigan game, good for Michigan. I mean, Michigan is really good. I mean, I can get all my Michigan friends and relatives, including my sister-in-law, off my back. Because they say, you don't ever give Michigan any credit, which is probably true. Well, I'm giving them credit now, okay? Michigan football looks good. They handled Iowa.
Yep.
I thought Iowa had a puncher's chance. Iowa had no chance. Iowa was the most disappointing team of the weekend, probably. The Alabama game, Tony, that young quarterback who should win the Heisman Trophy, that kid is brilliant. The combination of him and Nick Saban, I told you before it kicked off, I said, Tony, I'm not betting against Nick Saban. It's like betting against Bill Belichick. That's just throwing your money away. Just throw it away. It's a wave of goodbye. I'm not betting against them. And Georgia doesn't have, with even that great defense, they could not handle Alabama. So no surprises there. And I think it's likely to be chalk in the semifinals as well.
So I'm just going to take a couple of seconds to say this. The single most thrilling play of the entire weekend, college or pro, State Baylor. The sloppy game.
Yeah.
But on that play, when the Baylor kid rushed after the running back from Oklahoma State and caught him and knocked him out before he could reach the ball over into the end zone. That was on sheer will. That was the most thrilling play of the entire weekend.
Thrilling.
I agree with you about Alabama. We were told that Georgia had a generational defense. They'd allowed 7 touchdowns in 12 games. Alabama put 3 on them
shredded
in the first half.
Shredded them.
So I agree with you. You don't bet against Saban. I want to get to another point, though, and it's Cincinnati. Cincinnati deserves to be in this. But I want to hear from all the people who wrote columns saying they'll never be in it. The committee will never let him be in it. The committee will screw them. They'll never get in it. I wonder if anybody would say I was wrong about that. And we get to answer this one question, Mike, because they deserve to be in. But the question is, are they one of the 4 best teams in college football? So for me, I want to see Alabama-Cincinnati more than any game in years. For me.
What? Okay, I'm moving away every day from pick 'em and who you got. But Tom, we know the four teams now. Who you got?
Well, if Alabama plays like this, I got Alabama.
Yes.
Yeah.
They have the best coach ever, and they have this quarterback who's amazing. He's a marvel.
Yes.
I mean, he makes the right play. He makes decisions like he's a seventh-year player. His decision-making. And then he's got a rifle, and he's not tiny. You know, I mean, he's bigger than the kid on Arizona, and he's what, 6 feet? You know, 200 pounds, 190 pounds. What a great talent.
The kid in Arizona is a 5 foot 8 inch baseball player. Wow. Come on.
Man.
He's different. Kyler Murray is different. Let's take a break, but coming up, is it time to start taking the Dolphins and the football team seriously?
And it's tonight's game between the Patriots and Bills, a must win for the Bills. Michigan, I gave Michigan credit. Mason Blue, Allison, get off me. Stop. Leave me alone. I gave Michigan credit.
I'm glad for Harbaugh. I'm glad for
Pardon the interruption is presented by Truly Hard Seltzer. Live truly. Please drink responsibly. Part of Happy Hour.
Dion, hand it over. Now, how does that make you feel?
Like a part of me is missing.
Gabrielle?
This Old Spice Fiji Hand and Body Lotion has me smoother than ever.
That's what it does.
My mother gave me this ring when I was going through a really hard time in my life. And when she's going through a hard time, she has it.
We pass on this ring because we know we're always there for each other.
It's our sisterhood.
Celebrate your extraordinary love story. Save 25%. Jared, love brilliantly.
So, I'm watching Cinderella on Prime Video. Oh, I love her. Right, she sings that song. Oh, and that dress. Ooh, and that one. Got it. You know, the right look can make you feel super marvelous. Or like a king.
My princely robe's not on fleek.
When all the style is in one place, entertainment never ends. See where it takes you. Anything we wanted to, Prime Video. Anytime we want
to. Surprise, freeze are coming! Domino's has surprise freeze!
Other delivery apps add surprise fees, but Domino's is adding up to $50 million in surprise freeze to online delivery orders. And we tried some unique ways to tell people they're getting free food.
From Domino's!
It's the most joyous time of the year.
Especially at T-Mobile.
Let's go to Diane.
I got the awesome new iPhone 13 Pro and AirPods, and T-Mobile's paying for them both.
And this is for new and existing customers.
Upgrade to the iPhone 13 Pro and AirPods, both on us, only at T-Mobile.
This is your home. This is your family room, slash gym. The guest bedroom, slash music studio. The day bed, slash dog bed. The living room, slash yoga shanti, slash regional office.
How did you guys do it?
Slash classroom. And this is the basement, slash panic room. Maybe what your family needs is a vacation home, slash vacation home. Find yours on the Vrbo app.
I just win, that's what's up.
It's Saturday primetime. Warriors, Sixers, Saturday on ABC.
I love a good deal. I love finding good deals like this because this Fritos Chili Cheese Junior Wrap is 99 cents.
I feel like they just marked it wrong, but I'm not telling.
Right. Sonic Fritos Chili Cheese Junior Wrap.
Easy tools on the Chase mobile app. Simplicity feels good. Chase, make more of what's yours.
Don't be shy now. Like the prime cut.
Mm-hmm. Aflac.
I love my gold jacket, but that Aflac blue feels so right.
When you feel right, you coach right.
I know that's right. Prime never believed in double coverage, but the health insurance in Aflac is money.
Must be the money.
And I know how Coach Prime feels about money.
Now that is what this jacket needs.
Must be money.
Get help with expenses health insurance doesn't cover.
Aflac
is an official sponsor of ESPN College Game Day.
for an AFC East showdown on Monday night? Are Jones and the Patriots ready to reclaim the East? Are Allen and the Bills ready to defend it? Are you ready?
Welcome back to Pardon the Interruption, presented by Truly Hard Seltzer, part of Happy Hour.
It's mail time. You do the work. We make the money.
Oh, is that how that
Let's
works?
See what's Tom? First
Bill's
here.
To hear.
Are you still writing off the Dolphins and the football team?
I'm not writing them off. I'm not writing them in yet either. The Dolphins, of course, have won five straight now. And you keep hearing all these, you know, worthless stats. They're the first team to win five straight. Whoever lost seven straight, just so what? Shut up with that. They're a pretty good team now. They still have a lot of bodies to climb over to get to the point where they can get to the playoffs. And like the football team, the Washington football team, there's like, you know, it's like 20 teams, Tony, who are part of that solid middle class who are not out of it. And you can't write them off, but you're not going to go to Vegas and lay down a lot of money. The Washington football team, I think, will beat the Dallas Cowboys in the first of those two games. Then we'll see. It will set up drama for the second game against the Cowboys when they play two times in 3 weeks. Not writing them off, not writing them in.
Yeah, so I thought that the Dolphins were the most disappointing team in the entire league in the first half because they were a 10-win team last year, and they started 1-7, so good for them, and Tua looks like an NFL quarterback. But they're out of the mix right now. Washington's in the mix right now. If the playoffs start today, Washington is in it with their folk hero quarterback, Taylor Heineke. And as you say, they get their last five games. It's on their racket. All of those games are NFC East yep. games. Two with the Eagles, two with the Cowboys, including one this week, and one with the Giants. They win four of those. They win the division. Maybe even
That's
three.
It's going to be Maybe hard. I'll three. Take them against the Cowboys in the first of these games with some momentum going.
Is tonight's game against the Patriots a must-win for the Bills?
No, it really isn't. It's not a must-win for either team. You know, I know the marketing forces like to try to create these headlines and create these themes and these narratives, 80% of which are phony, baloney, junk. It's not a must-win because they both would still be in position to make the playoffs. So, but the wind up there, Tone, the weather's crazy. You know about that. You went to school close enough to there. Aren't those things worse than those nor'easters, which get much more attention? But these things in Buffalo and Western New York, I've been to that stadium when that wind is blowing and the goalposts are blowing and it feels like the stadium's shaking. And I'm like, nor'easter, take your nor'easter and get out. These things in Buffalo, I don't know who favors. I think all the weather favors the Patriots, but what do I know?
I don't know why it favors the Patriots because Buffalo lives in it all the time and the Patriots don't live in it all the time and it's a wind off the lake. Look, I agree that it's not a must win in terms of the standings.
Right.
But it is a must win psychologically for Buffalo. They're at home. They had Super Bowl aspirations. The Patriots did not. They had a quarterback that they thought was an MVP candidate. The Patriots had a rookie. I think if Buffalo loses this game, the Patriots go to 9-4, Buffalo 7-5, and the Patriots have a game in hand.
Yeah.
Nobody saw this coming with the Patriots. Nobody.
No.
Big deal game for the Bills, I believe.
Last one.
Here we go. One more.
Big deal, but not must win. A little difference.
Was Kenny Pickett's fake slide fair or foul?
Tony, anytime a quarterback slides, he is given the protection of by policy in any league on earth now. You start to slide and people ease up. They're not going to knock your head off. That kid not only has forfeited the benefit of the doubt going forward for him, but he's put other quarterbacks in danger too. Because if I'm a defender now, it's head off time. It's kill the quarterback, which has been the name of football for 100 years. And you know what? You lose the benefit of the doubt. That was smarmy what happened there. I'm sorry. I'm a defense guy. Knock his head off.
Okay, so I loved the play. Loved it when I saw it. Absolutely loved it. It was executed to perfection, and it got a touchdown. But, and there's always a but, he should have been flagged right there. The ball should have been right there. Because there was a contact with the defense.
Yeah.
They let you slide.
Yes.
If you fake a slide, more importantly than what happens to Kenny Pickett in a bowl game, is the next quarterback who goes to slide may get hit anyway and may get hit in the head.
Take the 15.
It's
knock somebody
out. It's a bad precedent, even though I love the play. It's a bad precedent. Enough email. Let's take one last break. Still to come, the Lions, they get their first win.
Man, what drama in that game. And we have a major move in the college coaching ranks. It seems like we can say that every day.
In that game as well, you were 20 seconds ahead of me, and you told me what happened.
I didn't tell you.
I ruined the moment.
I just screamed. I didn't say touchdown.
You screamed.
I didn't say.
Game Picks is brought to you by T-Mobile. With nationwide 5G coverage, T-Mobile keeps you in the game coast to coast with Monday Night Pick'em on the ESPN Fantasy app. T-Mobile, the leader in 5G.
It's delightful.
Seriously? But it's a total train wreck.
It's obvious that you've put a lot of work into it.
She's probably happy because she found out Honey Nut Cheerios can help lower cholesterol.
Does anyone want to go on a bike ride?
I need 3 Fritos Chili Cheese Junior apps.
Adding Fritos. Order up.
Sonic Fritos Chili Cheese Junior app.
Hulu has live TV. Hulu has live sports?
They do.
Hulu has live news?
That is correct. And Hulu also has
live talent show.
It also has over 75 live channels.
Uh-huh. Woo!
Huh? Flip like cable, stream like Hulu. Time to have Hulu plus live TV.
With less moderate to severe eczema, why hide your skin if you can help heal your skin from within? Dupixent helps keep you one step ahead of eczema with clearer skin and less itch.
Hide my skin? Not me.
Don't use if you're allergic to Dupixent. Serious allergic reactions can occur, including anaphylaxis, which is severe. Tell your doctor about new or worsening eye problems, such as eye pain or vision changes or a parasitic infection. If you take asthma medicines, don't change or stop them without talking to your doctor. Ask your doctor about Dupixent.
Hey, you! Domino's is giving away $15 million in surprise frees.
Other delivery apps add surprise fees. At Domino's, we're giving out surprise frees instead. When you order delivery online, you could be surprised with free food.
I love it.
From Domino's.
My mother gave me this ring when I was going through a really hard time in my life. And when she's going through a hard time, she has it.
We pass on this ring because we know we're always there for each other.
It's our sisterhood.
Celebrate your extraordinary love story. Save 25%. Jared, love brilliantly.
Gifts for elves, check. Now just in a dang coupon code.
Hold your reindeer, Santa.
Samuel, what's up?
I got a gift for you. Capital One Shopping instantly searches for available coupon codes and automatically applies them. Just download it to your computer. It's free.
Whoa.
Ooh, I have that. Saved me a bundle.
You have that?
Mm-hmm.
What?
So, that get me off your naughty list?
Are you off the naughty words?
Yes.
I don't think so.
Capital One Shopping. It's kind of genius.
What's in your wallet?
Prostate concerns? Get Super Beta Prostate, the number one brand that outsells the competition 4-1, and the brand recommended most by urologists. For your prostate, make sure it's Super Beta Prostate.
I am the greatest woman of all time.
I did not want to make another call to a dealership. I had really nothing but bad experiences buying things that I didn't want to at rates that I didn't want to pay. This wasn't anything like that process at all. It was completely different. I was getting the car that I wanted at the price that I wanted and from a person that was quite honest and upfront with me.
Dallas Lease Returns is the back-to-back-to-back Texas Used Car Dealer of the Year. I think you should come see why.
Food. We think about it all the time, but for many Americans, it's a scary thought. During this crisis, 1 in 12 seniors and 1 in 7 children don't have access to nutritious food. We can all help. Get involved at feedingamerica.org.
Standing by for Monday Night Countdown. Tonight in Buffalo, the Bills and Patriots have to...
play in this? Can you even throw the ball?
Let's find out.
Let's go.
It's moving. It's moving. Oh, my God. It's moving.
Pardon the Interruption is presented by Truly Hard Seltzer. Live truly. Please drink responsibly. Part of Happy Hour.
Happy time, people. Happy 27th birthday, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Every piece of NBA hardware you can get, Antetokounmpo's got it. He's a two-time MVP, a five-time All-Star. He was Defensive Player of the Year. He's now an NBA champion, and he was MVP of the Finals. Antetokounmpo was just named to the NBA's 75th anniversary team, and he may not even be halfway through his career. Antetokounmpo is averaging almost 28 points and 12 rebounds so far this season to go with 6 assists. He's the greatest basketball player in Milwaukee since Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and we bring that up because Antetokounmpo recently said his next challenge may take him elsewhere, as it did Kareem.
Tom, the champs struggled out of the gate. I mean, at one point, there are a couple of games under 500. You go, whoa, what's happening? Giannis held that together. Now, even though he's missed a couple of games recently, they seem to have righted the ship, as they used to say. I think the Bucks are going to be just fine.
Happy anniversary, Derrick Henry, on this day 3 years ago. Henry exploded for a Tennessee franchise record, 238 yards rushing, including an NFL record-tying 99-yard touchdown run in a 30-9 win over Jacksonville. Ooh. Henry finished that game with 4 touchdowns. We bring this up because even after being injured in Week 8, Henry's 937 yards rushing this year still ranked second in the NFL to Jonathan Taylor entering Week 13. And lately there have been multiple reports that Henry might return to the field in late December or early January, which would make Tennessee a formidable playoff opponent.
The season and the product overall is diminished when you don't have that man. Did you see that clip where he stiff arms 3 different dudes on his way to the end zone? Anybody done that since Jim Brown? I mean, my God, he is a force, and there's no one person equal to him in taking him down defensively these days. Nobody.
Happy trails to winlessness for the Detroit Lions. The Lions finally ended their winless drought yesterday on a last-second 11-yard pass from Jared Goff to Amon-Ra St. Brown for a 29-27 victory over Minnesota. A questionable fourth-down call by Lions coach Dan Campbell allowed Minnesota to score a touchdown with a minute 50 left and take a 27-23 lead. Detroit was up 23-21 when Campbell decided not to punt from his own 28 and trust his defense. But it all worked out in the end when Goff drove the Lions 75 yards without a timeout and hit the game winner. The Lions' 15-game winless streak had dated back to last December when they beat the Bears.
I'm glad the Lions won. I was rooting, as you know, Tony. We talked on the phone. I wanted the Lions to win. But that decision to not punt the ball, to go for it on fourth down, and to just give the ball to the Vikings, that's the dumbest decision I have ever seen made in football. I don't know how much is being criticized elsewhere. It's unbelievable, Tony. If I was playing on that team, I would have looked at this dude and said, really? That's our coach? In that one division, you got Nagy, you got Dick Campbell, you got the guy at Minnesota. I mean, dude, just please deliver me from the head coaching, a lot of it in the NFL, particularly in that division and particularly in that game.
You wanted the players to take Campbell's stuff and throw it out in the street.
One omission.
The Horace Medina Spirit, whose Kentucky Derby victory is still under a cloud because of drugs that were administered against the rules, died of a heart attack today after workout. That's very sad. Let us go to the big finish
if we could.
Miami fired Manny Diaz and is hiring Oregon coach Mario Cristobal. That's quick. Is it a big deal?
Well, it's a big deal in the Cristobal house where you get that Mel Tucker deal, 10 years, $80 million, almost. Big deal nationally? No. Oklahoma's hiring Clemson defensive coordinator Brent Venables. Is he a good hire?
He was at OU for a couple of years, 3 years, I think, or maybe more than that, maybe a long time. I don't know that I would go defense. I thought that Oklahoma's calling card under Lincoln Riley was offense, and that was the attraction. I'm a little skeptical. UConn's Paige Beckers left the Notre Dame game with a knee injury. Is that cause for concern?
Yes. She's a great player, Tony, and essential to the game. And I just hope it's not ligaments. I don't want to hear that word. Victor Hovland won the Hero World Challenge after my man, Colin Morikawa. He lost a 5-stroke lead, sort of gave it up, Tony. Is that significant?
These are two of the best young players in the world. I'm sort of stunned that Morikawa did that.
Yeah.
I mean, I figured he had that totally in hand. Last one, college basketball. Alabama upset number 3 Gonzaga. Is that a big deal?
I don't think so, Tony. Purdue's number 1 now, but I think they're going to be 8-10 number 1 teams. They're going to shuffle and rotate between now and the start of the tournament.
We're out of time. Trying to do better the next time, and I'm Tony Corn.